rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun.
Hey guys, Lizard Jones Reptiles back here with another YouTube video. Sorry I'm posting this one so late, I forgot to make a video on this too. So, the previous video I posted was on my crayfish molting, and I guess he just went over here and died, which is kind of not what you want. You'd rather have molting than that. And so I got these two new ones, I got these two guys. I'm going to be upgrading them to a 20 gallon once they get bigger, of course, because I don't want two crayfish this big in the tank running around killing each other. And then we got, so these two are in here. It's a guy and a girl. Hopefully they'll mate. May I sell some of you guys the eggs? So there's a female. Take a better shot on here. Sorry for the glare. Alright. Yep, that's her. Crazy looking she is. She's a lot, they're a lot more active than the original one they had. I think the male might still be in his burrow. I can't tell though. You guys let me know if you can see anything back there. Oh yeah, actually he is still in there. I don't know if you can see that for a second there, there's whiskers. His little hideout was a lot harder to look into than hers. And actually, I'm surprised that she went out and he didn't. Oh, she's a crazy. They're crazy. Yesterday, so I put these algae wafers and shrimp pellets in there. And they run around exploring the cage. Oh, and I got this new plant in here. Well, they run around exploring the cage, you know, saying whose burrow's whose. And that can also work as a hide, by the way. And so they both went on over here at the same time. The guy found one of the algae wafers, started eating on it. She started eating on one of these shrimp pellets. But this is a feeding dish. But also she tried climbing up the glass right here. He was right here eating like a pellet, one of these wafers. She was right here eating, I think, this pellet. And so she started climbing up like this, and she kept falling on over to him, and he's like, trying to get her away from his wafer. Then he freaking ran over here and grabbed this wafer and pulled it back because he didn't want her taking it. Because she kept falling into him. It's so funny. But yeah, I replaced the shark for this thing because I feel like the shark was just not a good hideout. What else? I guess that's just a tiki looking thing. I don't know what kind of plants these are. Oh, whoa. Sick. Look at that. I don't know what she's doing over there. But she's something. Anyway, but so yeah, this tank, probably around Christmas, is going to get 20 gallon long tank, 20 gallon long, I got the security camera watching them, that's on night vision, 20 gallon long tank, and a nice 20 through 50 gallon filter, it's probably the same light, probably a better one too, especially get two of those. I like using UVB to grow the plants. And it can also help with their exoskeleton. But, so, nice lid like this one. Nice lid. There's this plant, I don't know what it's called. I think it's called fire moss or something like that. And it grows a blanket of grass across the entire thing. And I want to get that. Like a nice planted aquarium. For my crayfish. Get, like, maybe three more hides. So I want them to have in a variety. When they get older, they're going to get a lot more aggressive. And crayfish, when they're aggressive, can get kind of brutal. And you can see this plant is doing amazing. That one back there is also doing amazing. This new one, I just planted it, so I don't even know how it's doing. But, yep, here's what I'm feeding them. Omega 1 shrimp pellets. Where's the company? Sinking Balls. Where's the company? Oh, Omega C. How dumb am I? Okay, so we got the API alligator pellets. It says for alligators, but since these guys are omnivores, this is perfect for them, because these guys love eating up algae, stuff like that, and this gives them enough calcium to keep lasting them, and it allows them to molt their shells and have a good one underneath, and they can molt with a lesser chance of having a stuck molt, you know. When they try to get out, and they can't get out, because they're stuck inside, because I think it's too much copper in the water, not enough calcium, and maybe too hard of, or too soft of water, I don't know. But there she is, coming around the side over there. Don't want to point the light directly at her. Actually, I probably should turn the light off, hold on. Alright, we got the light off, so maybe now she's not gonna run away. Okay, yep, she's doing okay over there. These guys are a lot more active than the other one. Maybe in that nighttime, these guys are a little bit more active in the day, which is one of the main things about electric blue crayfish, and they're called electric blue crayfish because, they're blue, and two, electric, as in they're extremely active. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Oh, what am I doing? Forgot. Okay, the male's name is Ebra, the giant lobster from Godzilla. And then her name, I haven't made up a name for it yet, so if anyone sees this video, then they can leave a suggestion if they really want to. That'd be helpful, because I'm not good at making names. That's why I got a name from a movie. A movie instead of making up my own name. So yep. Please like and subscribe and hit that bell icon if you want to be notified when I do post these videos. And I hope you enjoyed. And anyway, Lizard Joe Reptiles out.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no...